Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Brandy and we're here to speak our truth. And today's topic is going to be Bullied Part 1. I have a lot of stories, so I don't want my videos to be so long, so I'm breaking them up into parts. So based on some comments and some, I thought I would clarify and do this video about me being bullied. So, oh my God, I hope I have lipstick on my teeth. Sorry. So we're going to start from elementary school. Let's just say I was always taller than everyone in elementary school maybe third going into fourth grade. So I was even taller than the teachers, a lot of them, not all of them, but a lot of the teachers. So that's second grade at Westport. Oh, some of you are going to be watching this video are going to know exactly what I'm talking about. In some of this video, if you're watching this, it's going to be about some of you. I will not say anyone's names, which I do. Not which, that's the wrong way. I do remember all of you. Let's just say that. So I won't say anyone's name, but I will talk about the incident. So second grade at Westport. We lived in Westport in the projects. My foster mom, me and my siblings, my two sisters, and my foster mom's daughter, which is my aunt. But I'll get into that story another time. First day, first week of me transferring new girl into the school. First day, first week of school, I was banked. So for those of you who don't know what the Baltimore term, or maybe it's not a Baltimore term, I don't know, but banked is, it means you get beat up by several people at one time. So within the first week, I remember as the first day, but it may not be the first day. I mean, this was second grade. I mean, goodness, we're 36 now, some of us going on. I definitely remember that like it was yesterday, though. Like, I did have breasts in the second grade. I was an early developer. I can't tell now because I don't really have any. But I did have breasts in the second grade. So I guess I was, you know, boys tried to touch my breast in second grade. It may not have been. At some point during that first week, I got banked. I do remember the names of these people, which I'm not going to mention. But people who were there, you know who they are. They took my notebook, threw it in the trash, threw my book bag in the trash. And they basically just stomped on me. Teachers didn't do anything. No one did anything. I mean, this was Westport. People who know about Westport know the teachers ain't do nothing. To, you know. It was about four or five of these young people stomping on me while I laid on the ground. This was indoors, so I wasn't on the ground. I was indoors on the carpet, I guess, balled up in a ball while I'm getting stomped on for no apparent reason. I was shy. I didn't run my mouth. I never ran my mouth because I was shy. And just 2 years prior, I was just getting raped by a family member. So I didn't have a voice, so I can guarantee that I was just being bullied for being new, being tall, having breasts, being quiet. I mean, who the hell knows? But, you know, it started then. And then each grade after that at Westport, it was always a reminder. Someone always wanted to remind me on how I got beat up in second grade and that it would happen to me again. And that was every year. I'm not going to say people names who did this and threatened me at this time, but if you're watching, and those of you who know who these people are, you know who these people are because you were there. So I never was a troublemaker. I never ran my mouth. I never did anything to anybody. But for some reason, I was bullied. I was smart. Maybe I was, talked about how smart I was, or maybe I came off as that way. Maybe that's why. Like, I really tried to justify why these kids wanted to beat me up when I was just, like, new and didn't bother anybody. Third grade. Third grade. Third grade. Of course, I grew taller. I didn't stop growing, which means I got teased every single day. I got called all types of names. Oh, and then my clothes didn't fit because I was in foster care. So she didn't have money to buy us things. She wasn't even getting money from the state at the time me personally, I was in second and third grade. We didn't move until about end of third, fourth grade, but to Mount Juana's. But anyway, so yeah, I got teased every day for being too tall, and then I would tell stories. And I know if one of the girls remember this story that I used to tell you guys, that I would be like taking pills to stop growing, and I would see doctors so that there was a problem with me growing and I couldn't stop it. And, you know, I would just tell all these type of stories so that people would feel bad for me and they would leave me alone. But it didn't stop. It didn't stop. I was just talking to my sister. My sister's my best friend, Jasmine. I was just talking to her about this, and I was saying how I just would just make up these stories so people would leave me alone. It would be time I wouldn't even go to school. Like, I would hide in the basement. My foster mom, nobody knows this. I would hide in the basement, like, underneath the daybed, and I wouldn't go to school. I would, like, not go to school every day. I would fake work and put, like, dates on it. And so if my foster mom checked or whatever, it would have made up dates. I did that all the way up into ninth grade, by the way. Sorry, foster mom. I didn't want to go to school. I didn't want to be bullied. And I didn't want people teasing me about things that I had no control over. I got my period before a lot of the girls in school. I had breasts before a lot of the girls in school. I was taller than a lot of the girls and the boys in school. And so I was a target. My lips, my natural hair was thick, really thick and poofy and long. I got teased for that. I remember a girl pulling my hair. And all of these incidents was at Westport. We're starting at elementary school. Elementary, middle, because I didn't leave Westport until eighth grade, and then went to Pimlico and got bullied at Pimlico too. But I'm going to get there in a minute. They would pull my hair. God, I was literally tortured, and I had friends. I had, you know, associates, people who associated with me, but I got your back if you get into a fight type of situation. No, it wasn't. It wasn't none of that. I mean, if they were those type of friends, they didn't express it to me. Like, I don't know. So I did have people that didn't tease me, who talked to me and associated with me. I had one of the girls, I can say her name because her this is positive, Ashley. Everybody who went to Westport know who she is. She was someone, Jonay, she was someone, these are people who was nice, like Jabre. I'm only saying y'all because y'all was nice and I don't have anything negative. I'm not putting out names to people who was negative to me. I'm not doing that. But people who were positive, I don't think there's a problem putting any names out there. Siobhan was like my first friend. And when I came to the school in second grade, like sharing like lunch boxes and stuff like that. So there were people in between who were placed in my life to help balance the bullying. But if you guys were, and you see this video, and you guys saw me getting bullied, there aren't any instances where I can recall these particular people being there to actually see these things happening to me, and then it was like, okay, I'm gonna do something. So that we're definitely gonna take that out of the equation. Like, oh, people was just, and maybe they were, I don't know. From my perspective, there weren't people who was just watching, who I became friends with, who just was like watching these things happen. So Ashley, Jonay, they helped me with my hair, talked to me. I was able to go back and forth into these people's homes, their moms. I met their parents. These, Jabre, Siobhan, these, Isis, these females were Isis, even though I got a funny story about you. I know you might already know what I'm talking about, but these people were, and if I'm forgetting anybody, I definitely apologize if I'm forgetting. These people definitely stood out to me because we met each other's families, and we spent a significant amount of Dwanis. How the fuck did I forget Dwanis? Oh my God. Niecy. These people were put in my life, befriended me throughout the bullying and the bullshit that was going on. But everybody was in their own world, their own lane, when it came to what was going on in my direct sight. And it, like I said, I don't recall every single detail. So if those females that I mentioned were with me and was like, y'all stop doing that to her and this and that and third, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Because sometimes we focus on the negative a lot. And because a lot of the negative stood out more than the positive, those particular females may or may not have said something, Isis in particular, because one of her boyfriends was one of the people who was bullying me. I know she probably said, I'm pretty sure, because Isis that type of person, I'm pretty sure she said something to him, you know. Oh, the males, oh, I got drugged by the males, drugged, however you want to say it, by the males at Westport, the school. Oh God. I got dragged to filth. I got talked about from everything to my grandfather. My grandfather dropped us off every single day. And when the bullying got so bad and intense, I just would walk to school or just not go to school, period. So got teased from the granddad dropping us off to the vehicle that he drove, to his name, to me, to my lips, to my complexion. You too dark for this. You're so dark for that. Your lips so big. I know that this is like elementary school, and maybe, like, I look at all perspective of things. I really do, because I'm that type of person. And maybe because I felt like a target, I was a target, maybe because I didn't fight back. I got bullied more and I got teased more. I didn't want to fight. I didn't feel like I had to, like, why? Why do we have to fight? Like, why? If I'm not bothering you and you're not bothering me, and we go to school and we interact, just, like, what the fuck? What the fuck? Like, I never understood that shit. I never understood that. Like, I'm minding my business. I'm not bothering anyone. But I'm constantly getting bothered and bullied just for being myself. If a teacher takes a liking to me, you're a teacher's pet. The teacher like me. The teacher can trust me because I'm not off the bonkers like one of y'all. But that is something that people can tease you for. And then starting school after being I'm going to therapy for sexual assault by a family member. And then I'm going to school and I'm getting bullied every single day. I'm not lying to you guys. Every single fucking day I was tortured or bullied. Somebody pulled my hair. Somebody threw something at me. I just didn't want to fight. I wasn't a fighter. And then as time went on in elementary school, I was like, I don't want my record messed up for college or middle school or high school. I thought about shit like that because I was always a nerd. Always a nerd. Always studying everything that I wanted to know. So I knew that when I came to, maybe because I was a nerd, maybe I got bullied because I was a nerd. Every time the teacher had a question, I knew the answer. All right, maybe that's why. Maybe that's why. I was always studious. You know, I was always done my work before everybody else. Maybe people felt intimidated by that, and that's why I got bullied. Maybe. But I literally got teased every single day about something about me. Something I had on, your pants, your shoes, which I couldn't control that because I was being taken care of by somebody who wasn't getting paid to take care of me. I was an addition. Me and my sisters were an addition to her already having 3 children of her own. So times was hard. But did these children know that? No, they didn't know. That's why I tell my son when I tell him I have a 9-year-old, I tell him when you go to school, you know, you never know somebody's predicament. You never know somebody's situation. You never know why somebody's lashing out. And a lot of people take what happened to me. A lot of people take that and they lash out. They fighting. I never did no fighting. I wasn't no fighter. Can't find no fight record. I could count on my hand how many fights I actually been in. And it's less than 5. Like, what the fuck? I just didn't see the need to fight. For what? I didn't have shit. So, what the fuck was I didn't pick on nobody. I didn't care about what nobody else had. Who wore what. I didn't care about that. I just got raped. I didn't care about none of that. I was happy to be out of an environment that I didn't feel safe from. And then I get put in an environment that I kind of felt safe, kind of felt, at least I had, you know, some food, roof, some clothes. They weren't dirty. And, you know, we had to eat at soup kitchens and shit, but at least we had fucking food before she started getting money to take care of us. Like, that struggle was hard as fuck. But these kids at school wouldn't know that. They wouldn't know that. All they see is a tall girl whose clothes don't fit. Her hair ain't never done. And then when it's done, she got these pickaninny plaits in her hair. And she's smart and she got boobs. And we in the second grade. Like, all right, I'm about to close this out because I didn't want this to be too long. I'm trying to keep my videos under 20 minutes. Oh, people, attention spans. Please like, comment, and subscribe because I'm going to be kicking out these videos back to back. I'm going to continue on with my part twos of the part ones from yesterday. So I love you guys. I'm going to pick up with this because I have to go on to middle school and high school of this story. Peace, love, and blessings. Love you guys. Bye-bye.